Hi, today we'll see 5 features you can use to setting up the layers panel in Affinity Designer, Photo and Publisher. So let's begin. Resize the layers panel. You can drag the layers panel outside of the default group and create a floating panel. You can resize this from the edges by clicking and dragging until you get the desired size. You can use a large layers panel to visualize more layers in a single look. If you want to learn more about panels, please check the video setting up panels in the description or in the card. Layer panel shortcut. Whether you are using a floating panel or a docking, you can assign a shortcut to the panel. You can go to preference or use the shortcut Ctrl comma or Command comma and select keyboard shortcuts. Now go to the view menu and find Studio Layers. Enter the shortcut you want to use, for example, F7. And now you can hide or bring back the layers panel by using the shortcut you just assigned. Show group thumbnails. By default, groups and container layers may look similar to regular single layers. The main difference will be a triangle arrow that allows you to expand or collapse the layers. But now with the labs update from Serif, you can visualize them as folders. To be able to see the folder icons, you need to go to the list icon in the upper right corner and select Show Group Thumbnails. You can decide if you want to look the folder icons or have a preview image of the thumbnails. Thumbnail size and checkerboard background. You can go to the list icon in the upper right corner and select the size of the thumbnail. Small will be a good option if you have a large number of layers, but if you prefer to see a preview image in the thumbnail, you can select medium or large. You can also select checkerboard background. This will show you the transparency represented by white and gray squares in the thumbnail. Find in the layers panel. Anytime you select an object in the canvas, you can right click and choose Find in layers panel. This will show you where is the image or object that you have selected in the layers panel. You can also make this process automatic every time you select anything on the canvas. For Windows user, you need to go to preference, select user interface and show selection in layers panel. For Mac users, go to the list icon and select auto scroll. You can also try this on Windows, but sometimes it does not work correctly. Extra tip: assign color to layers. You can right-click over any layers in the layers panel, and at the bottom you can assign one of the seven options: red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple, or gray. Let's go with blue. And for this one, green. You can use this feature to organize and identify your layers. You can remove the color with a none option. And it might seem more like a tip for a video about how to use layers, but the scriptwriter thought it was a good addition to the tutorial. So those were some tips about features that you can use to setting up the layers panel in Affinity Designer, Photo, or Publisher. I hope you found something useful, and if you have a question or idea, please use the comment section below or follow the channel on Twitter. Thanks for watching, and until next time.